The woman traces glyphs in the air, and you cringe, expecting a barrage of ice and fire. Instead, a bit of smoke sputters forth. She cries to the skies in frustration, in a recognizable rail-thin rasp.
My lord, I've loved you. I've obeyed you. What's my sin? How long must I suffer?
She sees you approach and punches her fist in your direction. Her face flushes red. It's her, the one that destroyed the ship to Fort Joy. The one that stole your mask. She wavers for a moment, and you see a flash of recognition in her pained eyes.
You. It is you, isn't it? You can hide. You're the one who crafted this unholy contraption. Most artifacts like this mask are long lost, but you craft them anew. Who are you? What are you? My, my, what a specimen. It will almost be a shame to destroy such an ancient relic. The one true god, the god king of all divinity, the one that will see those seven impostors put in their place. Not that you will live to see it.
She turns her head to the heavens once more.
I offer this sacrifice to you. Return me to your side.
What's this? I found something. Dead magisters. I wonder who did this. Ready.
Magisters aren't the only ones looking for me. But who is it? And why? Ah, my false faces. Not as fair as my true visage, but better than being seen as a monster.
You are you, but more. You are another, but you look to your hands, your belly, your feet. Flesh you don't know, molded into unfamiliar shapes. You cradle your aching head, where another's memories and wisdoms mix with your own. Your fingers trace a line from your head to your face, feeling not the creases of the mask, but the porous surface of new skin. You lower your arm, blink twice. You see him coming for you. You saw what he did to the others. You pray, you pray, you pray. You curse as the knife lances into your thumb, deflected neatly off one of the rough skin spores you and Thews took from the prisoner. A wet pop behind you. Thews on his knees, his spore cracked and smoking in his hand. Thin sprouts push from beneath his eyelids, his nose, his mouth. His screams choked beneath a single vibrant thistle blooming from his throat. You move to help your friend, but stop short. It's the elf woman, crouching behind Thews with her chains broken. She spits a phrase, Khmer Doran. And you are choking, the spore boiling in your hand as gas blinds you. You feel something stir in your chest, then shift, then tear. You hardly recognize him, but there he is, Alexander. You're shocked to see a sorcerer's collar around his neck. He seems so different now. Your mind is empty as a new moon. Something seems to have cleared it out, scrubbed. You see Stingtail cowering as Dallas walks past him by the beach. She smiles at him gently and says, "All will be delivered." You had a taste for wine and ale, as well as a variety of other sensual pleasures. Your heart is heavy. You know too much. It's all too much. You may... A bright light blinds you, then fades. You feel a tremendous power in your hands, but they are shaking so hard, suddenly you're on this very ship, crouched in a corner, hugging your knees. A figure approaches, an older woman. She reaches a hand toward you. You grasp it. The memories end. You are no longer Finn. You return to yourself with a jolt. You eat Griff's ham, and you see him putting animals, dead for days in the blistering sun, whole into his cooking pot. Probably best... Looking around for joy, you feel excited. A new environment to explore. A deluge of happiness. You played the flute. You wrote poetry. Early memories are overshadowed by a terrifying death, a tempest of tea. Another. No! You.
Can you feel it, human? Tell me what you feel. You understand, then? Ashes and bone litter the island, but where the sweetest scents flourish in the deepest tombs. Tell me, do you like roses? Friendly flowers, but no more than that. Only a rose can tame. Go and pluck the blackest of roses from the depths to the southeast, where the revolting seeds the rapturous. A dark figure wanders there. She understands these roses, why they take root. Allow the figure within to guide you, traveler. Now go.
Looking up behind you, Ifan leans in to whisper in your ear.
Let me do the talking here. This one's expecting me.
The hooded man exudes an aura of restrained menace. As he raises his head to speak to Ifan, the hood falls back, revealing the gleaming bone visage of an undead. They speak in urgent whispers. Suddenly, the undead's bony claw pulls an elaborate crossbow from seeming thin air. It appears to be enveloped in misty shade. He proffers it to Ifan, along with a single rank-smelling arrow. Before you know it, the crossbow and arrow are tucked away in Ifan's backpack, and the conversation ends... The hooded man exudes a restrained menace that near matches your own. As he raises his head, the hood falls back.
Ah, one of my own kind. Be not frightened of me, brother. There's far worse than my bite, though I see you hiding behind a mask. You ashamed of who you are?
He laughs. A dark and crackling sound that seems to make the ground vibrate.
Around here? You'll be lucky to last a day, regardless of your... But maybe I can help you out. If you've the coin. Trinkets and wonders I have here in my pack. The smallest of costs, I'll tell you. Barely a trifle. Oh, yes, that I do. Some older than even this isle upon which we stand. Trinkets from ancient humans. Relics from fossilized dwarves and what have you. What? You expect me to be carting Maxo's own staff around?
He stares at you silently for a long moment, then gathers his...
I'm sure I don't know what you're talking about. Not even a little bit.
Zaliskar chuckles unpleasantly.
For those with a strong enough will, there is always a way.
With a horrific rasp of bone scraping against bone, he bows.
Call me Zaliskar. Naught else concerning me is yours to ask. My business is my own, and none of you look like one to know already. The source in you, I can smell it, I can feel it clinging to every dusty bone of your cadaver. There's ones like you close by, the Seekers. I came here with them. But magisters sank their ship. Sorcerers, like yourself, seek them out and you might find what it is that they seek. The ones that live still, cowering in some shrine in the depths of the swamp, twiddling their bleeding thumbs. If you're lucky, maybe you'll find them before something else finds you.
He spits something dark and viscous onto the earth. You notice the little horror wriggling deep into the soil.
If the little Seekers manage to steal the Magister's ship, the Lady Vengeance, maybe I'll find a way on board. Worry not about me. I have my methods. Worry for your own self. I only stock the best baubles, the choicest curios. Precious wares, are they not?
The hooded man exudes a restrained menace that near matches your...
Be not frightened of me, delicate fleshed one. Yours, for instance. Oh, shame those lizards. Spoil, tell me, did he only make you dig them daggers deep? Or did he make you... Indeed, my dear. The cad calling himself a cook is correct. I am Zalaskar. I'm a lone wolf. I'm afraid I must decline. You can eat the living, Sibyl, but I doubt you can suckle the secrets from my drug. I've known life and death and the wasteland in between. Do you really think you can intimidate me? Oh, but that won't do at all. You really shouldn't have threatened to harm one of my brothers in arms. I have no other option now.
Isn't it? mine.
Zaliskar's shriveled heart is tough to chew. The stringy meat is so vilely bitter, it brings tears to your eyes. You see him sitting around a campfire with a band of lone wolves, laughing as their leader... Roost is the leader's name. He boasts of how he caught you in his snares and delivered you to the master. You must find Roost and have a chat. A blood-stained sign reads "The Hollow Marshes" in knife-scratched cursive.
Bones, be mine!
The dog is blinded by its muzzle, but it turns its face toward you, waiting for your answer. As she considers your statement, her nostrils start to twitch. She lifts her head and takes a long drag of the air around her.
Sorcerer! You! Sorcerer! Sorcerer! You!
Kill! Kill! Kill!
What's this?
I found something.
Thank you.
gave corpses to warn you away, but still you intrude on our rest. What's... No matter, our master was clear. None shall pass. Oh, sweet thing. If you think I'll spill the tale just because you asked, pretty, you'll be disappointed in this life and the next.
She reaches for her weapon.
Is that so? Well, why don't you give it over? Might be your walk out of the swamp after all.
The skeleton's jaw clicks.
Children playing with toys. Bracchus used those weapons 1,000 years ago and did not understand their power. These red brats are no different. But our master does not care for the Magister lambs. It's you, Godwoke, and the other wolves, and it's time to put you down.
Thank you. take you.
I sense great suffering ahead. The agonies of an era and beyond.
Heal yourself!
Something nearby.
Thank you.
did. Rubbish. Even more corpses here. Good riddance.
The serenity in the... This place feels like a refuge for the first time in what feels like... You feel the stat... The stone form exudes warmth. The stone form...
Oh, I don't feel so good.
She looks at you with wet eyes and...
Good to see you. You take care now. And don't you let me down.
The woman looks up as you approach.
What do you need? By all means, get an eyeful.
The shrine depicts the hum.